हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टिश्यूज। एज वी ऑल नो, एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑन दिस अर्थ इज मेड अप ऑफ सेल, राइट? इन केस ऑफ यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिज्म और सिंगल सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक अमीबा, अ सिंगल सेल परफॉर्म ईच एंड एवरी लाइफ प्रोसेस, whether it is excretion, digestion, ingestion, anything that is performed by single cell. But when we are talking about multicellular organisms, or we can say complex bodied organisms, complex bodied organisms, different cells perform different functions, and this is known as division of labor. Different cells perform different functions, and this is known as division of labor. Division of labor can be said that tissues, different organs are performing their specific function different from each other. This can be said as division of labor. Here I have used a term tissue. So what does basically tissue means? Tissue can be said as grouping of cells to perform specific function and attaining a specific structure. It can be said as group of cells attain specific structure and perform specific or common function. This is tissue. Tissue term was first coined by Bichette. Study of tissue is said histology. And this term, histology, this was coined by Mayer. Now let us see some functions of tissue. What are the major functions of tissue? The first function that we have already discussed is that it helps to give division of labor in case of your multicellular or complex bodied organism. And beside this function, the other important function of this grouping of cells into tissues is that it provides efficiency to multicellular organism. Provide efficiency to multicellular organisms. Tissues further form organ, and organ further form organ system. This grouping, that is formation of tissues from cells and formation of organs from tissues and then organ system, this grouping reduces the load on cell. As I have told you earlier, multicellular organisms need specialized structures to perform specialized functions. We require different organ for different functions. For example, respiration is done by lungs, whole of the respiratory system. Excretion is done by whole of the excretory system, which includes kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, urethra. Similarly, digestion is performed by our alimentary canal. This cannot be done by a single cell. So this division of labor and this formation of organ system reduces the load on a single cell to perform various functions. So these are some functions of tissues, and further now we will discuss about multicellular organisms and the tissues which are involved in it. So after function, now let us see that multicellular organisms include what type of tissues. Multicellular organisms include animals, plants, algae, fungi, all these organisms come under multicellular organisms. And here particularly we will discuss about animals and plants, the tissues that are involved in animals and plants. Animals and plants, although being multicellular, but their tissues are not same. Their tissues are different from each other. And why is that so? There are many differences that make animals and plants tissue of different types. For example, animals are mobile, right? They can move here and there. However, plants are stationary. They have to stay at one place and perform all the function. So, plants require more supportive tissues rather than animals, and that is why most of their tissues are made up of dead cells. In case of animals, animals require tissues which are living to support mobility. The other difference that make animal and plants tissue different from each other is that plants grow throughout their life. However, animals, after being matured, they stop their growth, right? After maturation, growth stops. But in case of plants, growth is continuous. So, plants require specialized tissue which can help in their growth, जो कि उनकी lifetime growth के लिए help करेंगे, and those tissues are known as meristematic tissues that we will discuss later on. Another difference in case of animals and plants is that animals and plants have different structural organization. Their organization is such that according to their environment, animals and plants have both have organ system and that whole of the organism, but their environment, their lifestyle is different, so their structural organization is also different. So that is all for today. In the next session we will take up plant tissues. Till then, study hard.